The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We're offering our Mass today for the good estate of our wonderful parish staff, for Lisa and Benita in the office, and for Barbara and Caroline, who are the housekeepers, who are still on furlough. We offer Mass for them in thanksgiving for all they do to help the smooth running of the parish, either by keeping my administration free from error, or for keeping me neat and tidy, and to help face the world and the dear parishioners. We're celebrating Mass today on the memorial of St. Bernard, Abbot and Doctor of the Church. Filled with by the Lord with a spirit of understanding, blessed Bernard ministered streams of clear teaching to the people of God. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. O God, who made of the Abbot St. Bernard a man consumed with zeal for your house and a light shining and burning in your church, grant through his intercession that we may be on fire with the same spirit and walk always as children of the light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord was addressed to me as follows. I mean to display the holiness of my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, which you have profaned among them. And the nations will learn that I am the Lord. It is the Lord who speaks, when I display my holiness for your sake before their eyes. Then I am going to take you from among the nations and gather you together from all the foreign countries and bring you home to your own land. I shall pour clean water over you and you will be cleansed. I shall cleanse you of all your defilement and all your idols. I shall give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I shall remove the heart of stone from your bodies and give you a heart of flesh instead. I shall put my spirit in you and make you keep my laws and sincerely respect my observances. You will live in the land which I gave your ancestors. You shall be my people and I will be your God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I shall pour clean water over you, and all your sins will be washed away. I shall pour clean water over you, and all your sins will be washed away. A pure heart create for me, O God, put a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, nor deprive me of your Holy Spirit. I shall pour clean water over you, and all your sins will be washed away. Give me again the joy of your help, with a spirit to further sustain me, that I may teach transgressors your ways, and sinners may return to you. I shall pour clean water over you, and all your sins will be washed away. For in sacrifice you take no delight, burnt offerings from me you would refuse. My sacrifice, a contrite spirit, a humbled, contrite heart, you will not spurn. I shall pour clean water over you, and all your sins will be washed away.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Harden not your hearts today, but listen to the voice of the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus began to speak to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who gave a feast for his son's wedding. He sent his servants to call those who had been invited, but they would not come. Next he sent some more servants. Tell those who have been invited, he said, that I have my banquet all prepared. My oxen and fatted cattle have been slaughtered. Everything is ready. Come to the wedding. But they were not interested. One went off to his farm, another to his business, and the rest seized his servants, maltreated them, and killed them. The king was furious. He dispatched his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burnt their town. Then he sent to his servants, "The wedding is ready, but as those who were invited proved to be unworthy, go to the crossroads in the town and invite everyone you can find to the wedding." So these servants went out to the roads and collected together everyone they could find, bad and good alike, and the wedding hall was filled with guests. When the king came in to look at the guests, he noticed one man who was not wearing a wedding garment and said to him, "How did you get in here, my friend, without a wedding garment?" And the man was silent. Then the king said to the attendants, "Bind him hand and foot, and throw him out into the dark, where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. For many are called, but few are chosen." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We have just prayed the midday Angelus together. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, And Abbot Bernard invites us to pause and consider her response, laying great emphasis on the implications of it. The angel has brought glad tidings unto Mary, and the angel, who is God's messenger, must return and give him Mary's response. She is offered the price of our salvation. If she says yes, then humanity will be set free. We implore you, Mary, to say yes, because we cannot afford for you to say no. And for this reason, all generations will indeed call Our Lady blessed. St. Bernard says Our Lady is more precious than any, more holy than any. He places Our Lady at the summit of all life, stating that while God exists in all creatures, he is found especially in those who are good and holy, and Our Lady's soul magnifies the Lord. And she conceives of the Holy Spirit. The Lord says to Ezekiel in the first reading, I mean to display the holiness of my great name. A Christian bears the name of Christ and so magnifies the Lord, making his presence felt in the world. By baptism, we are made temples of the Holy Spirit. God chooses to dwell inside us, and it all begins with the Blessed Virgin Mary. Christ takes his place in his mother's womb. The Lord enters his temple. He who was, and who is to come, God among us, comes to meet his people. In baptism, we hear the fulfillment of Ezekiel's prophecy. I shall pour clean water over you, and you shall be cleansed. Our response should be the same as Our Lady, who says, Be it done unto me according to thy word. But time and again, we need to be convinced that we have been judged worthy to be in God's presence and minister to him. Sin gives us a heart of stone. Baptism and reconciliation, however, give us a disciple's heart, and Holy Communion expands that heart so that it may be full of grace for God's purpose. At baptism, we received our wedding garment, an indelible mark on our soul, which must be brought unstained to heaven. When the invitation comes to come to the wedding, we should be found so about the proclamation of the kingdom that supernaturally we will find our place at God's table, the wedding banquet of the Lamb of God. But remember, many are called, but few are chosen. Therefore, we must not be caught without a wedding garment for risk of being thrown out. And today's parable suggests we will not be given the chance to explain ourselves. And so the ordinary means of salvation is baptism, and the ordinary means of its restoration is reconciliation. God may choose, of course, to use extraordinary means, but we cannot recommend that people search for them or hold out for them. The Word became flesh and lived amongst us, and by his passion and cross, he redeems the world, and it's how we are brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. We offer to your Majesty, O Lord, the sacrament of unity and peace, as we celebrate the memorial of the Abbot St. Bernard, a man outstanding in word and deed, who strove to bring order and concord to your Church, through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support. So that, encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels, with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenius in caelia terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun till its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary. your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
For all him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Preceptus salutaribus moneti, et divinum institutione formati, aut emus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur tua nomen tuum, ad veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum, da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
On your steps, which one is pet mundi, miserere nobis. On your steps, which one is pet mundi, miserere nobis. On your steps, which one is pet mundi, dona nobis.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love, says the Lord.
so that strengthened by his example and instructed by his teaching, we may be caught up in the love of your incarnate word, who lives and reigns forever.